स्टूडेंट्स, गुड नून. दिस इज निधि घेटिया. वेलकम टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल. सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द कलेक्शन ऑफ द ड्रग्स, दिस टॉपिक. ओके, सो लेट्स बी स्टार्टेड. सो टूडेज अवर स्टडी ऑफ द कंटेंट, दैट इज ड्रग्स कलेक्शन ऑफ द क्रूड ड्रग्स, दैन फैक्टर अफेक्टिंग ऑन द कलेक्शन, दैन ड्राइंग ऑफ द क्रूड ड्रग्स, दैन मैथड ऑफ द ड्राइंग, then preservation and protection of the crude drugs, then physico chemical factors or properties, okay, then biological factors, then method controlling to insects and storage of the crude drugs. Okay, these all are the topics today we will discuss. Okay, so first topic, that is collection of the crude drugs. So the drugs may be collected from the wild or cultivated plants. Okay, drugs may be collected from the wild or cultivated plants. Okay, so in the it is known that the active constituents of the medicinal plants are affected by the many factors and may during the course of the plant growth. Okay, so many constituents are growing in the medicinal plant by the affecting by the many of the factors in during their plant growth period of the their plant. Okay, so proper time of the collection is a very important to obtain the drug of the good quality. Okay, so proper timing of the collection is must be required. Okay, now we see the factors affecting on the collection. So first factor, that is the time of the year. So the plant may contain a substance in winter, the winter that is not present in the summer. Okay, or its amount vary markedly. Example, like the rhubarb containing no anthraquinone in winter, instead of the containing anthranol, which is the summer and are oxidized to anthraquinone. Okay, rhubarb having no anthraquinone in winter period. It's anthraquinone only in the having in the summer period. Okay, summer season. In winter season, they having the anthranol. Okay, so many of the plants containing the substance in winter, so that is not present in the summer. Okay, some chemical constituent are the present in the winter, or some are the present in the summer season. Okay, so colchicum free from the bitterness and divide in of the alkaloids colchicine in antum. So antum, that is the mixing of the duration of the before the starting before the winter and ending after the summer. Okay, that's a 3 month period starting from the 1 September to ending with the 30th of the November. Okay, so this period called the antum, also monsoon. Okay, we are called this season, that is a monsoon, in and also called this antum. Okay, so hence it is Australian as the food. Okay, so used as the Australian is a food, that is a colchicum. Then instead of the potatoes, and bitterness start to appears in the sparing and earlier summer when it is the used as the drug. Okay, in Australia, colchicum that is used as the food. Okay, instead of the potatoes, replaced with the potatoes in the antum season. So bitterness started to appearance in the sparing and early of the summer. Early of the summer, that is the before the starting of the summer, they having the bitterness in their fruit or the their chemical constituent having the bitterness effect. Okay, so now we see the second one factor, that is the time of the day. Okay, so some of the drugs like digitalis containing different amount of the active constituents in the different time of the day, so being highest in the afternoon. Okay, as the some drugs are having the good constituents in morning time and some having the afternoon session. So here we take the digitalis example. So digitalis containing a different amount of the active constituent in different times of the day. okay, so being the highest in the afternoon, in highest chemical constituents having in the afternoon session of the day, okay. And third one, that is a stage of the maturity and age. So as per the age and maturity of the plant, they having the also effect on the their active constituents. So the value of the content of the active constituents of the many drugs depends on the stage of the maturity and age. Okay, so conium fruit, they contain the conin. So when the fruit are mature and unripe, so they having the good chemical constituent, that is conin, in the mature and unripe fruit. Okay, after the maturity level is higher and age is the higher, so they know having the much amount of the active constituents or effect of their active constituents. Okay, and then Santonica flower are the rich in the Santonian. So some unexpected when expanded, when it started to open, and Santonin contain the decrease. Okay, they flower, they are growing up, and they Santonin constituent it contain are the decrease. At reach, they Santonin at reach, they are unexpanded position of their flower. Okay, so now we see the drying of these crude drugs. So first we see the reasons of the drying of their crude drugs. Okay, so first, that is a preservation. First reason, that is the preservation of their drug. And then second one, that is the second reason, that is a fixed of their constituents, or by preventing reaction that may occurs in the presence of the water. Okay, then preventing the growth of the microorganisms such as the bacteria and fungi. And then facility their grinding process also, then reduce their size and weight, and then insufficient drying. Favor and spoilage by microorganism and make it possible by enzymatic destruction. Okay, these all are the reason for the drying of the crude drugs. First, that is the preservation reason. Second one, that is the constituents and preservating reaction that may be occurs in the presence of the water. Okay, unwanted reaction are followed in there before the drying process. Okay, and then preventing the drugs, they preventing the growth of the microorganisms such as the bacteria and fungi before the drying process. Okay, so it's also having the growth of these some microorganisms, then facilitate their grinding. Okay, in also we convert the after the drying process, we convert into powder, then reduce their size and weight, and then insufficient drying and favors the spoilage by the microorganisms and makes the possible to for the enzymatic destruction. Okay, these all are the reasons. Now we see the method of the preparation drying. Okay, sorry, method of the drying. So drying is the carried out either by the natural and artificial. These two methods, that first, that is a natural, and second one, that is the artificial. So first, natural, this is the accomplished by the natural air in sun or sheds. Okay, and second one, that is the artificial. So this is the rapid method done at the well controlled temperature and accomplished by the direct fire or heat and stone, and also used to or use of the stove. Okay, these all are the these three sources for the artificial drying process. In natural drying, they are drying in the availability of the sun and their sheds. Okay, natural air with also use of the natural air. Okay, these two types of the drying process, natural and artificial. So now we see the drying process in disadvantages of the artificial natural drying. Okay, so drying should be done carefully to prevent the damage or burning. Okay, at the level of the drying position, the chemical constituent are the damage either that burning, because the longer time of the drying process are followed there. Then excessive heat cause the gelatinization of the starch as well as the smoky odor. Okay, after the drying process completed, they having the some smoky odor or some starch gelatinization of the starch also there. Okay, now we see the method for the drying as the drying chamber. Okay, these all are the artificial machineries for the drying process of their drug. So this method provide a controlled process. Then drug chamber or a drying chamber consist of the closed space with the several movable screen tray. Okay, also having the trays and then arranged so as to allow their circulation of the heat in air. Okay, heated air, and its temperature is and ventilation can be regulated to suit drying of the different organs. Okay, like stem, leaves, as per the different organs, they are having the different temperature and ventilation process are manually we are regulated. Okay, so in this process, first we see this figure for the oven. Okay, hot drying oven. So in this oven, they having the some trays for the arranging the parts of the plants, and they closed, and after the heat circulation in all the trays, and they we are manually set the temperature and ventilation for the drying process, for depends on the different organs of their plant. Okay, this is the drying chamber, this is the hot air oven. Okay, now we see the lyophilization, freeze drying. These are the figures or pictures of the freeze drying machines. Okay, so it's having the three types, typically manifold dryer, then self freeze drying, and then combination lab freeze dryer. Okay, it's having the freezing process and with also drying process also there. Okay, now we see the chemical drying using the desiccator. So as an absolutely drying drugs is that completely freed from water. Okay, in desiccated dryer, drug constituents are completely after this process, the drug constituents are totally free from the water. When they exposed to the air, is absorbed 8 to 10% of the moisture, and this called the air dry drugs. Okay, so this is the desiccator dryer. Then now we see the several changes may be occurs on the drying. Okay, several changes. First change, that is the size and weight. So decrease the size and their weight because of the loss of the water from these drugs. Okay, so decrease the due to loss of the 80 to 90% of the water for in several changes on the drying process. Okay, first change, that is the size and weight, because they lose the water 80 to 90%, so their size and weight also decreases. Okay, and then second one, that is the shape and appearance. So some drugs several are on the drying, so other have their surface wrinkle and reticulate. Okay, so they also affected with the shape and appearance of their drugs. Third one, that is the appearance. So the method of the drying also affected in the appearance of the some unorganized drug. Okay, like yellow when rapidly heated and cooled, they produce the homogeneous glassy mass, but when slowly heated and cooled, they produce the heterogeneous aqueous mass, opaque mass. Okay, in yellow, we are going to discuss yellow as an example. Okay, rapidly heated to yellow. So and after the heating, they suddenly we cooled, so they produce the homogeneous glossy mass of their constituent. Okay, or mass of the yellow. Then when we slowly heated and after the slowly cooling process, they produce the heterogeneous opaque mass of the yellow. Okay, also they affect on the appearance. Then fourth one, that is the texture. So drugs on the drying become the harder, like the roots, then brittle, that is the leaves, then while those the containing starch become horny. Okay, drugs on the drying become the harder, brittle, and those containing the starch becomes the horny. Then colors, fifth one, that is the color. So generally on the drying process, drugs are mostly losing their color and they convert in the another color change. Okay, so color change also possible in this drying process. So generally on the drying, drug color drug become the darker in the color. And in certain cases, totally change of their color occurs in example like the poppy. When fresh on scarlet, scarlet that is a red, and drying process become the dull violet color. Okay, then tea leaves totally change. In fresh tea leaves, they having the green color, and after the drying process, they having the almost black color. Okay, then flowers maybe lose their color, especially when red or blue. Due to the destruction of the anthocyanins pigment, so responsible for the color. Okay, so color also totally change in the drying process. Okay, then order. So hyoscyamus and digitalis lose their bad order on the drying, and oris acquired present order in drying. Okay, so order also lose then. Test, so test also affected, this may be altered. Okay, so fresh gentian is very bitter, become the pleasant on the drying. Fresh gentian is the very become bitter, okay, and after the drying process they convert into pleasant order. Then constituents, so some drug containing sensitive constituents as the cardiac glycoside may undergo certain degree of the hydrolysis during the drying process. So first fresh vanilla pods contain the glucovanillin and glucovanillin alcohol. So one drying hydrolyze of the both glycoside and oxidation of the vanillin take place. Okay, constituents also drying process also affecting in the chemical constituents. Okay, so some drugs containing sensitive constituents like the cardiac glycoside, their example that is the cardiac glycoside, so may undergo this a certain degree of the hydrolysis during the drying process. Okay, hydrolysis process are follows in some sensitive constituents. Okay, so during the drying process, so first vanilla pods, okay, this is the very sensitive constituents, vanilla pods. So they having the glucovanillin and glucovanillic alcohol. These two constituents are present in their vanilla pods. And then on the drying process, they follows the hydrolysis process, and both of the glycoside oxidation to making the vanillin and tech plus. Okay. So now we see these some changes are favorable, and hence the condition should be made suitable and encourage such changes. Okay, so on the other hand, certain changes are undesirable and conditions should be controlled to guard against their occurrence. Okay, so as per the method of the drying, some changes or some methods of the drying are also follows. So in this, some changes are the favorable, okay, depends on the favors, and the, hence the condition should be made suitable and encourage such as these changes. Okay, and on the other hand, certain changes are undesirable and condition should be controlled to guard against their the occurrence. Okay, so now we see the preservation and protection of the crude drugs. So preservation, that is the storage. So store represents the last stage of the preparation of the crude drug. Okay, then drugs usually deteriorated along the time of the storage, expected in a few cases like example that is the cascara and frangula, should not be used expected after the certain period of the storage. Okay, at the longer type of the storage, they lose their chemical constituent. Okay, so drug usually deteriorated along the time of the storage, after longer time of the storage. Okay, then certain drugs as the noxomica are hardly affected by the storage. Okay, hardly affected. Nux vomica, that is hardly affected by the longest duration of the storage. Okay, then generally changes that take place during the storage of the crude drugs are objectable, like the drugs containing volatile oil gradually lose their aroma. Okay, volatile oil that are usually gradually lose their air or aroma, like the smell or their constituent effect. Okay, then improper method of the storing and adequate protection during the storage can cause the pronounced deterioration. Okay, so this here two principle of the deterioration, reason of the principle of the deterioration. So first one, that is a physicochemical, that it's having the moisture, heat, air and light. Second one, that is the biological, fungi, bacteria, insects and rodent. These all are the coming factors or principles for the deterioration. So now we see the physicochemical factor for the deterioration. So first, that is the moisture. So moisture sometimes affected drug adversely through the activating the enzyme, as in the cardiac glycoside. Okay, moisture sometimes affected the drugs adversely through the activating their enzyme, as the example, that is the cardiac glycoside. Second one, that is the heat. So rising of the temperature up to the 45 degree activated the enzyme, causing the decomposition of the chemical constituent. Okay, higher at the higher temperature, rising the temperature. Okay, so they up to the 45 degree, so the enzymes are the activated and decomposition of the chemical constituents or active constituents. Okay, and the volatile oil they containing the drug are also affected by the higher temperature and constant content are the decrease. In the volatile oil we are going to higher temperature, so their oil is the losing their constituents. Okay, contain of the chemical constituents. Okay, then third one, that is the air. So oxygen of the oxidizing certain chemical constituents of the crude drugs. Okay, oxygen are present in the air. So some drugs are oxidized in air, so constituent are also loose or some effect on some effect having on the their drugs. Okay, so linseed and lemon oil, so it cause the rancidity of the fixed oil and rancification of the volatile oil. Lemon oil, that is the volatile oil, and linseed, that's having the fixed oil. Okay, so in fixed oil that causing on the rancidity, and volatile oil that causing the rancification process. Okay, then fourth one, that is the light. So it affect drugs, especially those having the marked color. So some colors are totally changed in the presence of the light. Okay, too much light. So yellow color of the rhubarb they change to reddish tint. Okay, in the deterioration factor. Okay, then white color chlorals turn to brown. Okay, this is the physicochemical factors. Now we see the biological factors. So biological factors, in first, that is the bacteria. So cotton fibers are rendered brittle by the bacteria attack, so which make the cotton wool objectable and this dusty. Okay, bacteria, it's also biological factor on the drugs, crude drugs. So cotton fibers are rendered brittle by the bacterial attack, which makes the cotton wool objectionable and dusty. Okay, then mold. So the mycelium and of the delicate hive produce the unpleasant mash of the clinging particles in the powder drugs. Then insects, so they seem the attack all the drugs, but having the preference or to certain drug, as the zinzer, belladonna, cola and licorice. insects affect on the seems to attack all the drugs, but most having the preference on the certain drugs. So insects are affected on the ginger, belladonna, cola and licorice. These all are the drugs are attack with the insects. Okay, so insects which infant vegetable drugs included the beetle, mitas and moths. Okay, moths. So they render drugs porous and powdery. Okay, insects are also affected in some vegetables or drugs, and including with the beetles, then mites, then moths. Okay, and they also render the drug porous and powdery. Okay, so now we see the controlling of the insects. Okay, moth method of the controlling. First one, that is the heat treatment. So it is the simplest method and done by the exposing the drug to a temperature about 60 to 65 degree. It is the effective especially for the insects egg which are not affected by the insecticide. Okay, so heat treatment, so at the drug are exposing the, it is a simple method. Okay, then done by the exposing the drug at to higher temperature, that is around 60 to 65 degree. Then it is the effective especially insects egg, okay, which are not affected by the insecticides, any powder or the insecticide drugs which are not affected of the insect eggs that are affected with the temperature. Okay, so heat treatment. Then fumigation. Okay, fumigation. So this is the done by the volatile insecticidal agents in closed area, like example that is a CCl4, then CS2 and CN. Most fumigant do not kill the eggs of the insects. It is the advisable to repeat the fumigation at the interval of two, being a better result. Okay, it's not kill the any egg of the insect, but they advisable they stop the they prevent their eggs making the eggs. Okay, that is the fumigation. Then liming. So liming is the certain drug as the ginger, nutmeg to protect the protect against the insect attack and provide the provide only partial protection. Then lower temperature storage. So this method is preferred to fumigant and liming. Adult insects, pupa, larvae and eggs are sometimes killed by the very lower temperature. Okay, low temperature storage. It drugs are arranged in the lower temperature for the killing of the insects. Okay, then exposure to alternate periods of the low and high temperature. Sometimes drug are arranged on the lower temperature, and after the sometimes they are arranged on the higher temperature for the killing purpose of the insects. So frequently is more effective to for the killing insects than the prolonged period of the lower temperature exposure. Okay, sometimes higher and sometimes lower temperature. Then rodent. So they cause the spoilage of the crude drugs during the storage. So especially if wrapped in a paper cloth or put in the cardboard, okay, or wooden container. So the presence of the rodent filled excrete hair cause the rejection of the drugs. Okay, rodent. So these is cause the spoilers of the crude drug in the during of the storage condition. Especially it's wrapped in the paper or cloth or putting in the cardboard and wooden containers. So it's rodent in the filth extract and hair causing this rejection of these crude drug. Okay, so now we see the storage process of the crude drug. So first process, that is the it is the facilitated for the medicinal material should be well aerated, drying and protected from the light, and when necessary be supplied with the air conditioning and humidity control and humidity control equipment as well as facilitate to protection against the rodent, insect and livestock. Okay, some drugs are arranged in the drying protection of the drying process after the protection of the light or some air conditioned required their temperature or humidity or humidity control equipment, as well as they protect against the rodent and insects and livestock. Okay, before, after the drying process, these all are the storage condition for the drug. Okay, so the floor should be tandy without cracks and easy to clean. So medicinal material should be stored on the shelves, so which keeps in material sufficient distance from the wall. Okay, distance from the wall. It drugs are stored in the one cell. Okay, so they are some distance from the wall. So measure should be taken to prevent the occurrence of the pest infestation and mold formation, rotting or loss of their oil, and inspection should be carried out at the regular interval. Okay, then third one, that is the continuation process. Quality control measure should be implemented to eliminate substandard materials and contaminant and foreign materials prior to during the final stage of the packaging. Okay, so processed medicinal plant material should be packaged in the clean box, dry blocks, clean box, sack box, then bags and container in accordance with the standard operating procedure. Okay, SOP. As per the SOP, we are storing the drugs in a dry, clean, dry shake bags or box, or as the national and regional regulation of the procedure and ensure end user container. Okay, this is the third condition for the storage area of the drug. Standard or substandard materials contaminate, the drugs are not contaminated with the foreign metals or any foreign matters or any chemical considered at the final stage of the packaging. So that's why packed in the clean dry box, then sacks and bags or other container as per the standard operating procedure. Okay, then fourth condition, that is the material used for the packaging should be non-polluting, clean, dry and in an undamaged condition, and should conform to the quality requirement for the medicinal plant material concerned. Okay, so fragile medicinal plants material should be packed in the rigid container. Okay, so they are not fragile. Okay, then fifth one condition, that is a dried medicinal plant or herbal drugs including essential oil should be stored in a dry container, well aberrant building in the which daily temperature fluctuation are limited and good aeration is ensured. Okay, dried medicinal plant like herbal drugs including as the essential oil, that is volatile oil, okay, should be stored in a dry area, then well aerated building and the daily temperature fluctuation are limited and good aeration is ensured. Okay, then sixth one condition, that is a fresh medicinal plant material should be stored at the appropriate lower temperature, ideally 2 to 8 degree of the centigrade, and frozen product should be stored at the less than 20 degree of the centigrade. Okay, then seventh position, that is the small quantity of the drug could be readily stored in the air tight moisture proof and light proof container, so such as the tin can, then covered metal tin and amber color glass container, small quantity of the crude drugs could be readily stored in the airtight box or moisture proof or light proof container like the tin can, cover metal tin, then umber color glass container, then eight one that is the wooden box and paper bags should not be used for the storage of the crude drugs. Okay, wooden box and paper bags should not be used for the storage of the crude drugs. Okay, so now we complete this topic, that is collection of the crude drugs. Okay, so I hope you all guys enjoying this video tutorials. So thank you.